Did you know that Apple made some surprising changes to the iOS 18 version of the Photos app? They made some improvements to the app, but they also removed several key slideshow features from both the iPhone and the iPad. In this video, you'll discover what Apple removed as they work to streamline the whole slideshow presentation experience. I've received around 70 comments from people asking where their favorite slideshow features went. Many have expressed frustration with the limitations under this new OS. So let's talk about what Apple removed. In iOS 17, you had two options to create dynamic photo presentations. The first was a feature that Apple called Slideshows, which shared a ton in common with the Mac version of the Photos app. Under Slideshows, which you could trigger from either the Photos library or from within Albums, you had a few different options. The first was Theme, which controlled how slideshows played back. The iOS 17 version of Photos came with 5 themes: Origami, Dissolve, Magazine, Push, and Ken Burns. Each had a different transition effect, as the names imply. 4 of these 5 themes are still available in the Mac version of the Photos app today, along with a few others. The next was Music, which let you see music related to the different themes, or music from your music library, not including any tracks from Apple's streaming service. The next feature was Repeat, which allowed you to toggle whether a slideshow would play in a loop. And after that was a turtle and rabbit slider that let you set how fast your slides advanced. Under iOS 18, all of these slideshow options are gone. iOS 17 had one other dynamic photo presentation. It was called Memory Videos. These appeared in the Memory section of the Photos app and used only the Ken Burns effect. Under iOS 18, the Memory Videos experience has totally replaced the older iOS 17 slideshow options. iOS 18 does have a feature called Slideshow, but it's just the old Memory Videos feature under a new name. You might ask yourself, why did Apple do this? My guess is that they are streamlining functionality to make things more consistent across their various platforms. Memory Videos had better sharing options than the older Slideshow. If you'll recall, there wasn't an easy way to share slideshows under iOS 17. Let Apple know what you think. They have made it easy for us to share feedback about this version of the Photos app. Join me in submitting feedback, including what you like, as well as how you think the app should change. You can go to apple.com/feedback/photos, link in the description. If you found this video helpful, you might want to check out this video where I take you on a walkthrough of iOS 18 slideshows, or if you're still on iOS 17, you might want to check out this video here. Drop a comment to share your thoughts. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.